Are we sitting comfortably? Are the lights turned down low and the shadows lengthening in the room? Are the curtains closed and are the doors locked? Good. Then let us begin.
Metheringham is perhaps most famous for the apparition of a young lady, described as being in her late teens, who has been seen many times standing in the road that was once part of the airfield. She is often described as wearing a pale green coat with a grey headscarf and is perhaps accompanied by the smell of lavender perfume. This apparition has, it is alleged, stopped cyclists, motorists and even pedestrians asking for help, telling whomever she waylays that her fiancé has skidded riding his motorcycle and is lying injured just a short way further down the road. Bruce Barrymore Halpenny claimed to have identified the young female apparition as Catherine Bystock, a 19-year-old woman who had lived at Horncastle, who was killed whilst riding Pillion on her fiancé's Royal Enfield motorcycle, which skidded and crashed on a wet road surface. The flight sergeant is claimed to have only been shaken and bruised, but the girl was said to have been thrown from the machine and killed outright. Bruce Barrymore Halpenny admitted that he had embellished upon the accounts of the story, which proved, he said, successful in catching out those who were pretending to have seen the ghost. I suggest that intrigued viewers consult volumes 1 and 2 of his Ghost Station series, as the waters have become somewhat muddied in the telling and retelling of encounters with this particular apparition. Ian wrote on the 26th of May 2008 that he used to work with someone who saw a lady one night trying to flag him down, but he kept going and then thought, what if this woman is in trouble or has car trouble? So he went back. He couldn't find anyone there. Ian adds that this man didn't believe in ghosts, but actually went a bit white when the tale was explained to him. On the 23rd of December 2008, there was an account from someone whose friend lived in a converted barn on the old airfield who had smelt a strong smell of lavender when passing the alleged haunted stretch of road. The forum contributor himself admitted that he gets an odd feeling in his stomach, a very strong feeling which he cannot explain. Ian Williams wrote on the Phantoms of the Ruhr Facebook page in 2011 that on numerous occasions while returning to Coningsby, while serving in the RAF, they would drive around the Metheringham site as a shortcut. On one occasion, a series of lights were seen by himself and two colleagues that seemed to come from the direction of the few remaining buildings on the airfield. From the Haunted Lincolnshire website, there is the account from a steward who worked in the Air Museum at former RAF Metheringham, who heard unexplained noises and experienced strange activity where the sergeant's mess once stood. He also felt a presence whilst in the Carey Powell crash room. Ian Calvert wrote on the 8th of October 2011 that on the couple of occasions that he had visited the former airfield at Metheringham, he found that as soon as he stepped onto the airfield, his camera batteries became drained. My visit to this sad and melancholy airfield in August 2012 was unfortunately rather uneventful, and the above female apparition failed to make an appearance, despite me taking station at the appropriate part of the airfield road junction with my motorcycle at dusk. Gary Ross informs me that she didn't make an appearance for the Lynx paranormal team either when they investigated there a few years ago. Although the road area was uneventful, the location of the memorial to No. 106 Squadron was a very atmospheric place, and as the light began to fail and I stood on the peritrack facing the memorial, the prevailing impression was one of great sadness. No spirits came forward to make direct contact with me, but on that summer evening there was a decided chill down my spine at that particular spot. Metheringham is one of the airfields that I feel compelled to return to conduct another investigation.
the session. So, if anybody here wants to come talk to me. Let's just try that. So, does anyone want to come talk to me? Can you tell me what your name is, please? Can you tell me why you're here? Can you tell me what aircraft flew out here? Can you tell me what number squadron you are? Can you tell me what rank you are? Can you tell me why you're here? Can you stay here at all? Or do you just come and visit? Could you tell me your name? I'll be able to hear you later on. This back, I'll process it. Okay, we're coming out 4.5 minutes. So, say before I finish. Right, thank you very much.
It was a long day in Lincolnshire. I had set off early and made my way to a number of Lincolnshire airfields: Metheringham, Colby Grange, Fiskerton, Wickenby, and finally Kelston, before making my way to Horncastle and a late evening to be spent at Woodall Spa. It was also raining quite heavily much of the time, and I was soaking by the time I made Wickenby. I was alone for the day, and I had a deadline of being in Horncastle at a certain time. I found I couldn't relax, take photos, operate the spirit box and the recorder, and commune with spirits on the airfields. This then is my account of RAF Metheringham. All the other airfields that I mentioned are stories for another time.